Hello everyone, I hope you guys are doing well. I'm Shubham and you're watching Let Create an App. So this is part 5th of Auto Layouts and Constraint video series. So in the past 4 videos, we have talked about the UI, which includes this one, this sign up and sign in, as well as in the last part, we have talked about this tab bar, as well as how we can change the route at the time of login. So we have covered all these things in the last previous parts. So if you don't have an idea about all these things, so please go and watch the previous videos. The link of the series was mentioned in the description as well as on the I button. So in today's part, we are going to cover this home screen. So basically this home screen is very easy, but we are creating this screen in some different way by using aspect ratio. So if you are a developer, you will think that we are going to fix the height of these buttons and the width will be vary. But no, we are going to vary the height also. So if the device is little bit bigger, these buttons are bigger. And if the device is small, these buttons are small. We will going to see this thing in the preview section. So let's start this video. And if you like this video, please don't forget to hit the like button. And if you have any query or suggestion, please post that thing in the comment box. And if you're new to the channel, please don't forget to hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon to get the notifications of all my other videos. So let's start the video. Let's create an app. So let's move to the Xcode, and we have created this step up in the previous video. So the first view controller, that is this one. So we have to create that screen on this view controller. So for that, first we have to take the, as we see in the screen, that we have to take this blue view, sorry, this one blue view. So we don't need to change the height of the view. So we just copy this thing. So for copying this view, you have to just press the Alt key and just drag and drop this view on your controller. So by doing this, this will copy the whole view. So we have to remove these elements which we don't need on this view. Something like this. Like this. Now we have to put the constraints to this view. And the constraints are from both the sides 0. And from top, it's 0. Something like this. So by doing this thing, we have just created this blue view. Now we have to just create one label, something like this, that you will travel by, because it will asking the user that from which transport you want to move. So just create one label. We can also let that label sign up over here, so we don't need to work more. So the text is, let me see the text. You will travel by, okay. You will travel by, something like this, something like this. And now let's change some properties of this text, that it should be a little bigger and it should be in white color. And one more property, that it should be a medium, not a regular thing, like this. So it's completely looking fine. Now let's give some constraints to this view. And as you know, that we will going to put a center horizontal and vertical constraint, because that is work perfectly over here, something like this. So now there is a question mark, is not there, okay, let's place a question mark, something like this. Now we have to create these two views, as you're seeing on the screen, these two views. So what is aspect ratio? Aspect ratio means aspect ratio basically used to control the height and width of the view. So if we didn't provide any kind of height or width to that view, we can provide aspect ratio. So if the screen size get increased or decreased, it will automatically manage the height and width of that view. So we are going to create these three views by using aspect ratio. So whenever there is a small device, these height and width of these views get small and get increased when the device is big. So let's see how we can do this thing. So let's move on this thing again and just drag and drop two views. So simply type UI view and just drag and drop view over here, something like this. And whatever height and width you want, just put something like this, and just put this thing at the top of this view, something like this. You can also do the same thing just like over here, there is no problem. So now I think we have to copy this view one more time. So let's change the color so that we can get something clear view, okay, like something like this. Now let's copy this thing by pressing Alt key, and just after copying this thing, this is not copied, okay, fine. Now this is copied. Now we are having a two views. Now let's give a aspect ratio to this view only. So just simply drag and drop something like this on the self and just press on aspect ratio. Now we have to assign a constraints to these views. So just let this view something on top of this thing, like something like this, and just give a top constraint to, initially we can assign 22 to 233, whatever the constraint, and then we will change in the further scenario. So now let's give a leading constraint, and that is, that should be 30, something like this. But still the constraints are not satisfied, definitely, because there is no trailing and the height and width are not fixed yet. If we provide a fixed height and width, then these constraints are satisfactory, but we didn't provide that thing, so these constraints are not satisfactory. So now let's assign the same thing for this view also, but the only thing, we are not going to provide the aspect ratio to this view. We only have to provide the same thing, like 233 from top and 30 from the right or trailing, we can say that. Now we have to place equal height and equal width constraint to this view, and one more constraint, that is horizontal spacing. So after providing horizontal spacing, all the constraints are satisfying, I guess. Yeah, the all the constraints are working completely fine. So let's change the color to these views again to white, so that we can identify the things, something like this. So I think we need to put some other color so that it should be visible to us, something like this. Now we have to create one more view. So let's preview this thing first, and then we will proceed further. So for previewing, we have to just assign a simple class to this controller. So let's create one class, and just create one class just over here. And this is our Cocoa Touch class. Now just click on this next, and this is our home view controller. So just simply type home view controller, and just create this class over here. Now remove these lines and move to the storyboard again. Now assign this class to this controller like this, and this is home view controller, something like this. So now we can preview this thing. So let's preview in different devices that how it's look like this. So this is an iPhone 8 thing. Now let's add one more thing, that is iPhone SE. So this is a smaller thing. So as you see, the width and height of these views are small in small device. And if we take iPhone 10, something like that thing, then it will something different. So let's see. And it's something different with this one. So, and we can also check this thing over here. Like let's do one more thing. Let's reduce the size of this view, this constraint. So just change it to 0. So if you see that height and width both get increased, like something like this. So at the runtime, the height and width of these both the views are getting increases. So this is a power of aspect ratio. So if you want to make some views, like they will auto resize themselves according to the height of the screen, then you can provide the same thing. So we change this thing to back 30, and this is completely fine. Now we have to create one more view, and that is simply again UI view, something like this. Now we have to give the leading constraint to this view, leading from this view, trailing to this view, and we have to provide two more constraints, that is top constraint, and we want a top like 18 pixel, and that is fine, I guess, completely fine. And the only thing which is left to this view is height. So we will provide a height to this view with equal to this view. So let's give the height to height. So all the constraints are satisfying, I guess. Yeah, there is no error. So all the constraints are perfectly satisfying. Now let's change the color to this view to something different, like this. Now if we will check these thing again, that aspect ratio is working fine or not, so that the height of this view is reducing or changing accordingly. So we can check this thing, just pass 0 over here, and as we pass 0, the height of this view get increased. And if we change the height of the view, this trailing constraint over here, so the height of the view is again increased. So let's see the frames, that this the height is 155. Now let's change the trailing constraint of this view again, and that is 30. And then we will check the height of this view. This is 30, something like this. So initially it was 155, now it's 129. So the height of the view is changed. So all the three views are created by using simple aspect ratio. So these two views is totally dependent on this view. So if the height of this orange view will get increased, the height of these two views, height and width of these two views will automatically increased. Now we have to place the image in this view. So if we have placed something like this, or we have created some view by using aspect ratio, then we can also create the subviews using aspect ratio. Something like we are going to create this thing. So we just need to import these images which I've already downloaded. So let's import these images first, and that was in the desktop, and these are the this one frame plane and the car, these three images. Now again move to the storyboard. So fix the height of this image view so that it will look a little bit cool. So the 55 and 55 again, and it should be center horizontal and vertical, something like this. And let's give the image to this is a, I guess, plane, this one. And let's change the background color of this view, that should be white. So it looks something like this. So it's a little bit below side. So let's give the constraint or multiplier like 0.7, something like this. Now place one label, so that is label, and put that label below this image and give it a plane, something like this. And you can try some other colors, just like there is something different. So you can try your own imaginations. So now that give the basic constraint to this plane label, and that is 4. And it should be center horizontal, sorry, vertical or center. So this is only constraint which we need to give to this view. Now we have to give one more thing to this view, that is that a class which we have created. We need to give one more thing to this view, that is a class which we have created, that is a custom UI view class which will provide a shadow to all the views. So that is UI view plus design, I guess. Custom, I think the name is custom view. Custom, something like this. Yeah, that this is the class. Now let's copy these two things and paste over here by just pressing Alt key, and simply give the same thing center, horizontal, and vertical to this view, and just change this thing to 0.7, and just thing which we require to give this view center, horizontal, center in the container, like this, and change the image to, I guess this is a train, like this, and change the background to color again to white, something like this. Now this is the last thing which we are going to create. So again, just copy this thing pressing Alt key, and just change this thing to car, and this is also car. Yes, we have forgot to change the name of this thing to train. Now let's change the background color of this thing to white, something like this, and give the constraint to this to center, horizontal, vertical. Again, provide this thing to 0.7, and this should be center, horizontal, and vertical. Center, horizontal, that's it. So we have created this thing. Now I guess we have to assign the class to every view, that is custom view, this one and this one also. This one. Now let's run this thing and check that it is working fine or not. So it will definitely come on the first tab of our controller. So let's see that how it's look. So this is looking something like this. Definitely images are not cool because I'm not having any images. I just cut these images from the image which I have from this one. So it's looks something similar. So let's see and check that how similar it looks like. So yeah, we can change the shadow radius of the image. Apart from all these things, it's look completely looking fine. Or we can also reduce the space between these two views. So this is completely looking fine, and these views are resizable according to its own need. So yeah, there is a spelling mistake of by. Yeah, that's a very silly mistake which I did. By. Okay, this one now. Now it's completely fine. So in the next part, we are going to learn something how we can make these things are clickable without using any kind of tab gesture. So this is also very, really very exciting. And apart from that, we are also going to learn how we can create this kind of UI. So this is very important thing because we are going to use the same method which we have created in the sign up and sign in screen for providing a right view to the text field. So these are something like that. So we are going to create this thing. So this is for today. If you like this video, please don't forget to hit the like button. And if you learned something from this video, please don't forget to hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon to get the notifications of all my other video. And if you have any query or suggestion, please post that thing in the comment box. Meet you in the next tutorial. Thank you.